If you want to set sail anytime soon, then your experience on the ship could be much different than you might realize, depending on whether or not you've been vaccinated. Like it or not, and whether it's even fair, cruising has been tied in many people's minds with the pandemic. Those early days when ships were quarantined and passengers and crew on board came down with cases ingrained a lasting image for many. It also led to cruise ships being one of the last things to return as vaccines rolled out and cases plummeted. Specifically, the CDC put no-sail orders in place, along with a tough framework to return. Known as the Conditional Sail Order, this framework provides the rules and regulations that cruise lines must follow in order to sail again. Having looked at the rules, the restrictions put in place by the CDC and cruise lines make sailing unvaccinated sound like a much worse experience than if you have the shot. Now, not everyone is eligible for the vaccine, but if you are, then it is a good idea to take it before you cruise. That's because your experience is going to be much worse, in my opinion, if you sail without that shot. Here's what you can expect on the ship. Want to ditch that face mask while you cruise? Then go ahead and get vaccinated. The CDC's framework lays out rules for mask usage on the ship, and they are much more lenient for those with the shot. For cruises with 95% or more vaccination rates, cruise lines are allowed to let passengers not wear masks around the ship. So whether you're in the casino, the theater, or hanging out by the pool, you don't have to mask up. If sailing on a cruise with a mix of passengers, however, but you are vaccinated, then masks aren't required for extended meals or hanging out at the bar. Cruise lines can also designate areas of the ship for only vaccinated passengers where masks aren't required. If you don't have the shot, however, it is different. You don't have to wear one outdoors, but inside the ship, anywhere other than your cabin, then it is mask on. Eating or drinking, you can't remove the mask for extended meal service or beverage consumption, according to the CDC. Similar to the mask requirements, the CDC orders for distancing are much better if you are sailing after being vaccinated. If the entire ship has a shot, then current rules say that distancing isn't required but only recommended. With no masks and no distancing, it's similar to sailing before the health crisis. That's certainly not the case, however, for unvaccinated passengers. In that case, distancing rules are in place around the ship. Restaurants, casinos, gyms, pools, and more must have plenty of space for all passengers to be able to spread out. Conga lines? That's a no-go. If you are inoculated on a mixed cruise like this, then the ship can designate areas where vaccinated passengers can visit where distancing isn't required. Now, one of the bedrocks of the plan to return to sailing before vaccines were introduced was universal testing of all passengers. The CDC required testing before embarkation and before leaving the ship at the end of the cruise. With no vaccines, this was the most important way of keeping the virus off the cruise ship. However, testing isn't fun for anyone, and it can be unpleasant depending on the method. With vaccines now widely available, the health agency has changed rules. Now, if you are vaccinated, testing isn't required before boarding or at the end of the cruise unless the cruise line decides to keep that rule in place. Don't have the shot? Then the CDC requires tests before boarding, at the end of cruises that are more than 4 nights, and between back-to-back sailings. Some cruise lines are warning that people eligible for the vaccine who don't get it or who refuse to show proof will have to pay for these tests. In other words, you'll get hit in the wallet in addition to multiple tests. One of the big changes announced to help keep passengers healthy was the introduction of so-called bubbles for shore excursions. Under this guidance, cruise passengers could only leave the ship on certain excursions that would adhere to health protocols. Those suggestions, they've eased somewhat. Now the CDC requires passengers that don't have the shot to only be allowed on excursions where distancing is in place and masks are worn. It is not required that ships keep unvaccinated passengers from heading off into port on their own like it used to be, but it is recommended. Vaccinated passengers don't have either of these things to worry about. According to the CDC, quote, cruise ship operators at their discretion may advise passengers and crew that if they are fully vaccinated, they may engage in self-guided or independent exploration during port stops. If masks, distancing, and testing aren't enough to show how much different life on a cruise ship will be for unvaccinated passengers, consider what happens if someone comes down with a case of COVID. Say you are sailing on a cruise and someone returns a positive test. In that case, the cruise line will start looking into close contacts of that person, which is defined as people within 6 feet of a person for 15 or more minutes. Are you vaccinated? The CDC says you only have to take a test if you are symptomatic, although the cruise line may ask you to test anyway. However, you don't have to quarantine if you aren't feeling symptoms. If you are unvaccinated, then it's a completely different situation. In that case, the CDC says that you need to be tested if you are a close contact, whether you show symptoms or not, unless you have documentation that you've gotten over the virus within the past 90 days. In addition, the CDC says a passenger needs to quarantine for 14 days. If there is one thing that's true, it's that as time goes on, these rules will change and evolve. We've already seen this happen considerably since the first rules were announced by the CDC months ago compared to today. It could be that as time goes on, assuming virus cases fall and cruise lines can sail safely, the sea of difference between rules for unvaccinated and vaccinated passengers narrows. For now, at least, there is a world of difference between sailing with a shot and sailing without. In fact, cruise lines even admit it. When Carnival decided to start back with vaccinated sailings, they sent a letter to passengers saying that, quote, "the current CDC requirements for cruising with a guest base that is unvaccinated will make it very difficult to deliver the experience our guests expect." In other words, sailing unvaccinated right now means a vacation that just won't quite be the same.